Hello students, welcome to my class. So in this class we are going to continue the remaining parts of the chapter nutrition in plants. In the last class we learnt about grass eating animals, digestion in grass eating animals. So far you have learnt about animals which possesses the digestive system, but there are many small organisms which do not have a mouth and digestive system. Then how do they acquire and digest food? So in this class we are going to learn another way of interesting way of taking food in. So our next topic is feeding and digestion in amoeba. Let me tell you about how amoeba looks like. There is no shape, means amoeba doesn't have any shape, as you can see in the picture this shape, but it keeps changes its shape. And amoeba is unicellular organism, means it has only one cell. We all know that human body is made up of millions of tissue. Means tissue is prepared by cells together makes tissue, but amoeba has only one cell. That is why it is known as unicellular or unicellular organism. So you can see how amoeba is obtaining nutrition in this picture. Let me tell you in detail. So firstly, you can see there is a dense structure which is known as nucleus. As you all know, amoeba has only one cell, but every cell has a nucleus and it will be there at the center. So this is the nucleus in amoeba, and this surroundings jo aaspaas ka ye jo area hai ye cytoplasm hai. So except nucleus, every part is known as cytoplasm. So in cytoplasm only food vehicles are present, as you can see, and these food vehicles helps in nutrition in amoeba. Let us see how. So whenever it finds its food, what it do? It pushes out its finger-like projection. These are the finger-like projection. It pushes out its one or two finger-like projection to catch the food. As you can see, this is the food particle. These are the finger-like projection. It pushes out to catch this food and takes it in. So in this way, amoeba ingest its food. Then after that, the food particle which ingest by amoeba can be stored in the form of a food vacuole. As you can see, these are the food vacuoles. So then it enters in the amoeba, then amoeba ka food digestion hota hai. Kaise? To digestive juices food vacuole mein secrete hoke, they break down the food into simpler substances, then digested food can be absorbed by the body, which provide energy and use for the growth, maintenance and multiplication of the amoeba. In this way they get the nutrients and the undigested part of the food comes out. Here as you can see, this is digested waste which comes out after the digestion. So this was the digestion or feeding process in amoeba. So the basic process of digestion of food and release of energy is same in all the organisms, all the animals. Let's do exercises. So the first question is fill in the blanks. So first question of fill in the blanks is the main step of nutrition in humans are. So what are the steps of nutrition in human? So first step, taking of food, which is known as ingestion. First step is ingestion. Then second step, digestion, can be digest after ingestion. Then after the digestion, what will happen to your food? It can be absorbed. So absorption. Then what will happen? Next step is assimilation. Let me write here. And last step is the food will comes out, which is known as egestion. Next question is the largest gland in the human body. We have learnt it. What is the largest gland? Which part is the largest gland in human body? Which is the largest gland? So the liver. Liver is the largest gland in the human body. Next, the stomach releases hydrochloric acid and dash juices which act on food. Which juices? The juices which are helpful for the digestion of food. So they are, that is why they are digestive juices. Next question is, the inner wall of the small intestine has many finger-like outgrowths or projection called dash. As we said, the finger-like projection or outgrowths which are present like this, we studied, are known as villi. And last question is, amoeba digests its food in the dash. Where amoeba digests its food? It digests its food in food vacuole. Next main is, mark T if the statement is true and F if the statement is false. Okay, we have to put T if the statement is true and F if the statement is false or wrong. So the first one is, digestion of starch starts in the stomach. Is it true or false? It is false. Next question, tongue helps in mixing food with saliva. Yes, we know that tongue helps in mixing food with saliva. It is true. The gallbladder temporarily store bile. So it store bile juices in the gallbladder. The liver store its bile juices in the gallbladder. So it is true. And next one is, the ruminant bring back swallowed grass into their mouth and chew it for some time. Yes, they bring the swallowed food or swallowed grass back to chew it again. Chew it for some time, then again they will transfer or swallow it into the different part. So it is true only. Next question is, tick or mark the correct answer in each of the following. So fat is completely digested in. So fat will be completely digested in which part? It is, is it in the stomach or it is mouth or small intestine or large intestine? So it should be small intestine. Fat is completely digested or all digestion complete in the small intestine only. Next question is, water from the undigested food is absorbed in the mainly in the dash. So we have learnt that water and salt can be absorbed in the large intestine. So the answer is large intestine. Next question is, match the atoms column 1 with those of column 2. So the first question is food components. So from here, which one? Products of digestion, fatty acids and glycerol, sugar or amino acid. So components, food components means they are the products of digestion. So it should be first one. Carbohydrates. What are carbohydrates? Sugar. Because sugar is the simple form of the carbohydrate. Next, protein. Amino acid. Because amino acid is the simpler form of the proteins. And fats. This one. Fatty acids and glycerols.